All right, thank you, Tony. We are tracking the latest developments in the Aaron Hernandez murder trial. One day after prosecutors rested their case, the jury was given the day off, but lawyers for both sides were back in court today for an important hearing. Eyewitness News reporter Susan Campbell joins us now from Fall River Superior Court with the Mobile Newsroom.
The jury was not here today, but attorneys were in the courtroom arguing motions for more than 2.5 hours.
Your Honor, that would conclude the
prosecutors rested their case Thursday. Now Aaron Hernandez's defense team is gearing up to call its witnesses. But first, the defense asked the judge to issue a not guilty finding, claiming the Commonwealth has failed to make its case.
Despite 2 months of evidence, it leaves not just gaps, but really gaping holes in the Commonwealth's case. And those are gaping holes that cannot be filled in by speculation.
The defense's motion was really a formality, but prosecutors still argued strenuously against it.
He's provided the gun. He's provided the car. He's the one with the relationship. He's the one calling Shayana Jenkins to get the number. He picks him up. He immediately then drives to a scene with there's no other reasonable explanation.
As expected, the judge ruled against the defense's motion.
Without engaging in speculation or conjecture, a rational finder of fact could find the essential elements of each of the offenses charged.
The defense will call its witnesses beginning Monday. On Monday, the judge will decide if Dr. David Greenblatt can testify about the effects of PCP. Throughout this trial, the defense has tried to prove that Aaron Hernandez's co-defendants Ernest Wallace and Carlos Ortiz were high at the time Odin Lloyd was killed. Coming up new at 6, both the defense and prosecution give their input for jury instructions. In Fall River with the Southeastern Massachusetts Mobile Newsroom, Susan Campbell, Eyewitness News.
Now the latest developments in the Aaron Hernandez murder trial. The case continued today without the jury there. Now lawyers for both the prosecution and defense argued motions before the judge for hours. And new at 6 tonight, we're hearing how both sides want to instruct the jury. Eyewitness News reporter Susan Campbell joins us now outside Fall River Superior Court.
The defense and prosecution both filed motions suggesting dozens of pages worth of instructions for the jury.
The firearm.
Prosecutors say this surveillance video shows Aaron Hernandez holding a Glock 10 minutes after Odin Lloyd was shot to death.
In my opinion,
Glock employee Kyle Aspinwall agreed, saying he believes the object in Hernandez's hand is a Glock. Now with jury deliberations looming, the defense wants the judge to remind jurors that she tossed some of Aspinwall's testimony.
Frankly, I think this is the centerpiece of the Commonwealth's case. This is the most significant evidence against Mr. Hernandez. And the other thing that's different about this, Your Honor, is the court struck it the next day.
The defense argued that gave the jury time to think and reflect on the testimony. And they say the jury may not be able to separate what's allowed from what's not allowed. Prosecutors disagreed.
It is like anything else that is struck. They're asking the court instead to highlight it. Which is inconsistent. There were a number of things that the court, after the fact, struck. The defendant didn't object.
The judge made a quick decision.
I'm going to tell him what I struck. This is in the context of being struck, and I'm going to.
But I'm asking the court to indicate to them what portions of his testimony you're not sure.
I'm not going to go through all of his testimony. I'm repeating the instruction I gave them.
The defense will begin calling witnesses on Monday. The judge said closing arguments could happen as early as Tuesday. In Fall River with the Southeastern Massachusetts Mobile Newsroom, Susan Campbell, Eyewitness News.